back very shortly.
You're late, Dad. We've already given them all.
You're on video. Don't get back to me. Yes. Yes.
He likes his food.
Oh, for goodness sake. Oh, no. Shakespeare and Christopher Marlowe were both born on the same year.
1564.
Christopher Marlowe died, Zuleika.
1593.
And Dr. Fanagan. Ah! Ah! So just
so
4 years on earth.
24.
What happens at the very end? Do you remember any other Shakespeare play I mentioned? I told you the story of.
Hamlet.
Yeah. And that may be one that you'd be lucky enough to be taught by Mr. Canning, Mr. Gurdon, Mr. Jemison. Now, you've all to ask me something.
What?
Where
was
Miss
Smith from?
She's before
that.
What's her name?
Mrs. Canning, who I also taught many years ago.
Big clue, okay?
What?
It's something you're not, and it's a word which contains every vowel in the right order.
Conscientious.
Serious.
Conscientious is one, but you're not conscientious. There's another one. There's only two words in the English language.
That contains all the vowels in...
Right order.
A-E-I. Serious. S-A-E-I.
Abstract.
Steamius.
Well done, that's Steamius.
Abstemious. Do you know what steamius means?
Is there even a word?
No.
It means, you know, you hang back when it means...
So I thought you were...
No, it means you abstain, you know, you don't eat very much, you don't drink very much, in other words, you know, you're...
I have a €100 bet on this. Is Miss Lawson Henry Rowe's cousin?
Well, yes, of course.
No, I don't know.
Well, I can tell you the correct answer. Yes.
Henry. Idiot.
Well, very, very quickly, nominations for the best book ever written. Quick.
Thomas.
Elskill Tyvel.
Going to strike the
My left
foot.
Oh, that
was
the curious incident.
The
curious incident. That's an excellent one. Michael. Or Peter Red.
Dr. Faustus.
Yeah. Tyrone Red. That book.
Tyrone Red. Mice and
Men.
Come on. Yeah, the same old.
What's the best book you've ever read?
The best book I've ever read. I'm sorry to say.
Go back.
When I was teaching.
Learning the plans.
Your father. Oh. Was reading another book under the desk.
By Julie Cooper. Once is not enough.
That's funny.
And it was, my very favourite book is The Portrait of a Lady by Henry James. And Mr. Gurdon, the poem that he read in The Voices of Poetry, was based on the first page of it. Because I also taught him that, but he liked it a lot better than Mr. Kemp. Well, it's brilliantly written, and I think the way he portrays this young woman who is full of idealism and is made very rich and then makes a disastrous marriage and feels that she's honor bound to stick to it. I don't know why it's so appealing, but I think she is one of the most interesting characters in literature. And it's the great test of a good book is that it bears rereading. This, by the way, that's why Shakespeare is even better than Henry James. Because he can teach his plays as I have again and again and again. And they just get better.